on the road to the national championship? Find out next. University is the setting for today's first round 1AA playoff encounter between the third seed Flying Dutchman from Hofstra and the 14th seeded Mountain Hawks from Lehigh. And of course, Hofstra wants to add to this trophy case. We're talking about championship hardware should they get to that championship game. Hi everyone, Paul Reuter joined by Marty Lyons. Hey, watch for the bump over there. First of all, before we get into anything, nice pair of slacks, nice sweater. Wrong belt. Not appropriate. I'm sorry. Not appropriate for the way you're dressed.
Well, see, Carl, you haven't given me respect all year. This is a carpenter's belt, and when you wear a carpenter's belt, you prepare to build something.
What are you building? What are you building?
You said they're playing for a trophy, the national championship trophy. I have to find the spot to put it here in the trophy case. And like Joe Gardy's been doing since day one, he's built this program up around the quarterback position. And this year is no different. You got number 19, Giovanni Tomasi. 21 touchdowns through the year, 11 rushing, and a smart quarterback, a great leader. He's only thrown 10 interceptions. If this team's going to have a positive impact on the playoffs, they have to ride the shoulders of their quarterback from us.
Well, somebody that will have a say-so on whether or not a championship trophy goes there is the quarterback for Lehigh. Talking about number 17, Phil Stambaugh. Like Carmazzi, a big guy, 6'4", 221 pounds. This guy is a prolific passer. Every year, touchdown ratio to interception ratio, 2-1. This year, no different. 26 touchdowns through the air, 2,995 yards passing. If he has an above-average game today, he will go over the 10,000 career mark in passing yardage. And the other thing about this guy, Stambaugh, oh, Marty, listen to this. He's got a bevy of receivers. He can throw to 6, 7, 8 different guys. He's got a host of guys that can catch the football, and they will do so today against a Hofstra defense that sometimes has trouble.
They do have trouble, but one thing I didn't mention, every member of a national championship team will get a ring, just like I did, 1978, University of Alabama. But first, more importantly, let's find a spot to put the trophy.
Just watch yourself,
I think,
please.
If you know, you put the, put a hole right here.
Doing.
I'll take a jigsaw, we'll cut it out, we'll put a light in behind it, we'll be fine.
Just watch.
Get us ready. Ow!
I told you to watch this song, you never listen to it.
Romantic piano music and flowers. Rare and exotic furnishings. Decor that evokes images of a bygone era. Experience our commitment to the highest standards of excellence, the finest quality, and the ultimate in service. Join us for a unique experience in an atmosphere of rare luxury and pleasure. Create memories that will endure forever at Chateaubriand.
The most powerful name in news, Fox News Channel, on cable 24 hours a day. Fair and balanced with the most powerful names in news. Special Report with Brit Hume, the political show of record. The Fox Report with Paula Zahn, powerful information. The O'Reilly Factor, where news is a contact sport. Hannity and Combs, right battles left. The Cavuto Business Report, powerful business. Fox News Channel, the most powerful name in news. We report, you decide. Hey, Islanders fans, if you can't get enough Isles info, you've got to catch Fox Sports Net's exclusive pregame show, Geico Islanders Game Night. Get team news, interviews, and game analysis. In-depth features and stories on your favorite New York players, plus stats, matchups, and plenty of highlights. Steve Cherkovsky, he scores!
Just got to keep going out there and do your jump.
Before they drop the puck, get the inside scoop on Geico Islanders Game Night, a half hour before each Islanders game, only on Fox Sports Net.
Dancing, the choir is a singing, the sleigh bells are a ringing. Never was there ever Christmas show.
The Radio City Christmas Spectacular.
It'll fill your heart with Christmas. Taking someone that you know.
Someone that you love.
To see the Radio City Christmas show.
Call today.
Still making their way into Hofstra Stadium, Hempstead, New York, the site of today's first round Division I AA championship game between the Mountain Hawks, seeded 14, and the third seeded Hofstra Flying Dutchman. Hofstra Stadium is the setting for this one. And the weather right now, well, not too bad at 55 degrees, wind out of the northwest, and it will gust a lot more than 17 miles per hour. And those guys right there in the middle of your screen will be just a little bit chilly by the time this game gets down to the fourth quarter when the temperature begins to drop. Paul Reuter, along with Marty Lyons, getting set for Hofstra and Lehigh. And the Lehigh Mountain Hawks did win the toss and deferred. So the Hofstra Flying Dutchman will come out first on offense. And we take a look at the Stearns starting lineup. First for Hofstra, watch the right side of the line. Michael Curry starting in place of Mike Rossigno. Might see action today, bad shoulder. Steve Jackson, 21, has been tearing it up against the opposition secondary. All-time leading receiver for Hofstra University. And he catches the aerials from this guy who next year will be in the NFL. Gio Carmazzi has set all sorts of records for the Hofstra Flying Dutchman. The Lehigh defense, and they have a very strong one at that. Again, defense led by, watch the guy in the middle there. They tackled Jason Stanley. Reuben Smith on the end, number 93, a good one as well. Ian Eason, the key linebacker for Lehigh. In the secondary, the senior Kevin Joseph does it all. He is a big play guy, number 9, the cornerback for Lehigh. The officials today are out of the Atlantic 10. The referee is Jack Winter. Doing the kicking off for Lehigh will be number 1, Jaron Tafe. He is a junior from Marietta, Georgia, and the deep man for the Flying Dutchman. Number 3, Robert Thomas to the far side. Number 11, Billy Morales to the near side. Billy Morales is an exciting returner, whether it be on punt or kickoff return. Morales, Marty Lyons, could be a key in this one. He could break one against this Lehigh team.
And don't be surprised if you don't see Morales running in there at super back position, giving Jimmy Jones a little break today.
We are underway. Far side, it's Robert Thomas from the 1. Robert Thomas to the 15, up to the 20-yard line, gang tackle. First and 10 coming up for the Hofstra Flying Dutchman. Joe Gardy in his 10th year on the sidelines for the Hofstra Flying Dutchman. The best winning percentage in school history. Look at that, he's coached 110 games. He's won 80 of them on the far side. What a great job, second year in a row that Kevin Higgins has taken the Lehigh Mountain Hawks to the playoffs. Last year in the first game, upset Richmond before losing in the second round to the eventual champion, the Minutemen from UMass. First play from scrimmage, Hofstra starts with twins split out to either side of Gio Carmazzi. Jimmy Jones is your super back, number 20. Good crowd on hand at Hofstra Stadium. The gift to Jimmy Jones. Hole opens up. Loose football, fumble. And the Mountain Hawks have recovered. Jason Pinckney. Just like that. Right off the bat, a fumble. Costly turnover.
Ian Eason, the linebacker for Lehigh, is going to come up. You see it? Jimmy Jones cuts it back inside the guard. But watch the hit by number 41. Ian Eason. And Lehigh comes up with a quick turnover. Very first play of the game. 41. Eason gets a piece of the football, and Lehigh, excellent field position.
First recovered fumble of the season for Pinckney. And this is Ronald Jean, the little guy, doing the job on the first carry. Ronald Jean out of Boca Raton, Florida, only 5'6", 183 pounds. What a story. We will get into it about Ronald Jean as we take a look at these Stern starters. And it's an offensive line that can open it up. Yes, Michael Ludwig and Steve Ludwig are brothers. Michael, the senior leader, right in the middle of that line. And these are just some of the receivers that Stambaugh, the quarterback, Phil Stambaugh, will throw to. Ronald Jean is the guy to look at, that little tailback, number two. Stambaugh has picked up big numbers. Now second down and short. They're calling it to Stambaugh to go to the air. Oh, a crunching tackle by Jimmy Emanuel. But the reception was made. Might be enough for a first down. Rick Moore on the reception.
Rick Moore is going to make this reception, but he's going to pay for it. Jimmy Emanuel, middle linebacker, comes up to make the stick.
Phil Stambaugh, the senior, pretty much all Patriot everything. He has put up dynamic numbers. The senior has, out of Rosetto, Pennsylvania. Looking for that quick toss, Cody Fedorcha, the intended receiver, number 83. Fedorcha is the leading pass catcher for this Mountain Hawk team. The Hofstra defense needs to come up big right now as we take a look at their 11 guys on the field. Carrie Williams could have a big game from that left end position. Get to the rest right after this. On second down and 10, Gene looking for room. Gene running under people, getting close to the 15-yard line. Ronald Jean, the leading ball carrier for Lehigh this season with 1,358 yards, also has 23 touchdowns. And what a story, Marty. At 13 years old, his mother said, you know what? Don't want you anymore. He told his mom, I'm not going to New York. I'm staying here. I don't need you anymore. I'm tired of the abuse that you've given me. His mother even knifed him. He's got a 6-inch scar on his chest. And look at what he's turned out to be.
He used it as the motivation that he needed. Look how successful he is, not just on the playing field, in the classroom also.
Stambaugh on third and four. He's under pressure and he's sacked. Phil Stambaugh brought down by Carrie Williams.
Good pressure by the defensive line of Hofstra. They're going to put the pressure on the quarterback. Bad snap by the center. Stambaugh right there, hanging in there. Carrie Williams comes around the corner. The snap. Watch Carrie Williams, 96, come from the outside, speed rush, comes up with a quarterback sack.
Carrie Williams now has 6.5 sacks on the season, which ties him with Jim Magda for the team lead. There had to have been a flag because they have now set it up with a first down and goal from just inside the 10-yard line. It was an offside, so negate the last sack. First and goal, Lehigh from the Hofstra 10. Ronald Jean, right side. Ronald Jean down to the 6-yard line. Brought down combination number 9, Asher Longden. Number 44, Jim Emanuel.
But again, number 2 for Lehigh, Ron Jean. He's only 5'6", and that's wearing a high pair of shoes. Roughly about 5'5", 183, very strong runner.
Marty, how difficult to tackle a guy that stands at only 5'6"?
Well, the hard part is trying to find him. He's behind those big offensive linemen. You don't know where he is. You have to cover your lane responsibility.
Gene, as I said, grew up in Boca Raton, Florida, but came from Freeport, Bahamas before Boca. Oh, tripped up there by number 37. Outstanding season for the junior from Mansfield, Massachusetts, Joe Todd.
Joe Todd coming on a run blitz off the corner. It's Gene just as he's going to get the ball. Watch 37. Joe Todd comes around the corner to make the stop.
Knocking at the door following the fumble on the first play of the game by Jimmy Jones. Lehigh facing a third and goal from the Hofstra 5. Played 3.5 minutes first quarter. Joe Todd's coming. Gets the Stambaugh and then Gene drops the pass.
Joe Todd coming from the backside again. All out blitz by the Flying Dutchman. They're going to put the pressure on the quarterback. Joe Todd, left side of your screen is number 37. Phil Stambaugh, he goes back. There's the pressure. Throws it low to Ron Jean. He can't handle it. Out to attempt a field goal.
Bring out Jerron Tate, this from 23 yards on the season. Tate, 8 of 13, has a long of 44. That kick is up, and that kick is good. So following the turnover, Tate able to turn it into 3 points, and Lehigh on the board first in the first round of this 1AA playoff encounter.
Good look at head coach Kevin Higgins for Lehigh, but Joe Guardi and his defensive coaches, they have to feel pretty good about themselves with the field position that Lehigh got, that last penalty to come away with only giving up 3 points. It's a defensive victory.
So the Hofstra team huddled up again. They will receive the kickoff. I'll tell you, there is Gio Carmazzi. And now he will play from behind. But as you said, Marty, could have been worse than the 3-0, could have been 7-0.
Well, one play, and then Jimmy Jones takes it up the middle, and he fumbles. The one thing you have to realize about Lehigh, coming from the Patriots League, they're very aggressive on defense. They don't have the size that Joe Guardi's used to facing week in and week out, but this team has excellent quickness.
The Patriot League, a non-scholarship league. So these are guys that are not on athletic scholarships. The Mountain Hawks from Lehigh, a sparkling record of 10-1 on the season. The only loss at Colgate a few weeks back, a 28-24 loss. In fact, Colgate also in the 1AA playoffs, taking on Illinois State. The winner of this game will play the winner of Illinois State and Colgate.
Which makes this game very interesting.
Absolutely. Again, Tate to kick off. Drives Robert Thomas back. In fact, Thomas just lets it go in and out. Touchback first and 10 from the 20 for the Flying Dutchman from Hofstra University, ranked fourth in the nation. And Lehigh, despite being the 14th seed, right now currently at 12 in the nation. The scoring drive, well, a little bit more than 3 minutes, and it was Tate with the 23-yard three-pointer. Carmazzi, the senior from Sacramento, California, again with twins split out to both sides. Jimmy Jones still at superback. So right back to Jimmy Jones, and Jones maybe a yard before he was tripped up by number 35, Bryant Appling, the junior from Lithonia, Georgia. There's Appling, 6 foot, 221 pounds.
And when you look at the numbers of Lehigh's linebackers, Carl, 315 tackles, 11 sacks, and 7 interceptions. Very active group.
Marty Hofstra spreading 5 now. Trips to the far side. Jimmy Jones slot near side. Inside 88, Charlie Adams. Shotgun Carmazzi. Billy Morales with speed. Morales tripped up as he crossed the 30 to the 33-yard line. Tripped up by number 24, Abdul Byron. A gain of 13 for Morales.
Billy Morales gets a key block by number 21, Steve Jackson, fellow wide receiver. Watch Jackson, number 21. He's got his man on the ground. And then Billy Morales takes it for a first down.
Quickly they come near side. Look at Morales trying to split the gap. And he crosses the 40-yard line. Jason Pinckney combining with 24, Abdul Byron. I asked Morales before the game. He said, finally, both hamstrings at 100%, although both are tightly wrapped. He's an exciting player, Mark.
Well, one thing I like about Billy, he'll give you 110% effort. You don't have to worry about his toughness. He's going to put it down, running north and south.
Jimmy Jones crossing midfield into Lehigh territory, chased out by number 30, Matt Salvaterra, a freshman at 5'10", 185, from Macungie, Pennsylvania.
Well, the one thing you want to do is you want to get the ball back in the hands of Jimmy Jones, number 20. He fumbled the first time he attempted to run, get it back in his hand. Get him comfortable running the ball.
This drive is shaping up. Hofstra on the move, trailing 3-0, inside 10 minutes left, first quarter. First round of the Division 1AA playoffs, Hofstra and Lehigh, Hofstra Stadium, Hempstead, New York. Pomazi in trouble, now fakes it, tucks it, and runs. And he was chased to the sideline by number 16, James Young, a junior from Morristown, New Jersey.
A sign that Gio Calmazzi has matured as a quarterback. He's not going to try to force it in. Tries to pick up some positive yards. Scrambles for four before he's tackled by number 16, James Young.
The numbers on Calmazzi, if he can throw, he can pick him up and put him down and picks up positive yardage from that quarterback position. From the 44-yard line of Lehigh. Second down and six, Tom Kemper in motion, 83 far side. Quarterback draw. Escape somehow. No, he doesn't. Brought down number 41, Ian Eason.
Again, Eason comes from the backside. This is a design play. Quarterback draw up the middle. Good pressure by Lehigh's defensive line. Watch the hole collapse right there. Nowhere to go for Calmazzi. And excellent speed by number 41, Eason, for Lehigh to make the stop for a loss of one.
Setting up third and seven for Calmazzi. Eason came in as the fourth leading tackler on this Mountain Hawks team. For the season, almost 40% third down conversion for the Flying Dutchman. Trips near side, stacked tightly. Calmazzi loses the football, but they say he was in the act of throwing. James Young was coming.
James Young coming right up the middle. Good pressure by number 16. Coming from the backside, Carmazzi's not going to see him. Watch 16, right side of your screen. He's coming in. Nobody there to block him, and Calmazzi gets hit. The ball goes incomplete. We talked about the quickness, Carl. There they show it again. Using their linebackers coming on a blitz.
Josh Snyder back to receive single safety, the punt of McClary. James McClary, the freshman, 47 kicks this year, averaging just a little bit over 35 yards. And Marty, this is a team, Lehigh, that loves special teams. They've already blocked a bunch of punts this year, and a bad snap, and McClary's in trouble, and he's just gonna try to pick it up now, throws it, completes it. It doesn't matter to Rob Levitis. And boy, oh boy, Hofstra shooting itself in the foot early on.
You talked about special teams being a big part of the game. James McClary at 6'6". Remember, the snapper snapping with the wind. The ball's going to sail over his head. Another look at ball well over his head. McClary's going to go back, try to recover it. Then he's going to throw it out to Rob Levitis. But again, a big special team play by Lehigh.
Fake to Gene. Stand ball looking for six. Wide open. Out of the end zone, Rick Moore. Wow. Stand ball showing off the arm. Moore just couldn't get those quick feet down inside the back of the end zone.
He ran out of real estate down there. Good play action fake. Quick turnover. Another look at the end of the play. Ricky Moore's number 14 goes up, makes the reception, and steps on the line.
Marty, I love the home run. I love trying to take advantage following a turnover. I love the play call by Kevin Higgins. I love to try to catch a defense flat. Ronald Jean swinging out. And look at him string out that play. Really read that well. Staying at home, 26. Doug Shanahan with help.
Along with the two linebackers, Rob Levitis, Jim Emanuel.
Jim Emanuel did a lot of homework. Saw him here yesterday, Marty, and he was bringing home tape. He has really studied Lehigh.
Well, you see, Gene, he can't turn the corner. Wide, number 35, Rob Levitis doing the job. And then Doug Shanahan gets credit for the stop. Sets up a 3rd and 10 situation for the Mountain Hawks.
This the best in the NCAA, Lehigh, on 3rd down conversions at 56%. Can they do it again? Lofting it wide open, the tight end, Bruce Peltzer. Joe Todd stops him at the 10. What a big 3rd down play.
But you have to like the play selection. Kevin Higgins coming out, misdirection. They're going to come back and find the tight end. From the reverse angle, you see the quarterback goes back. Stand ball. He's going to throw it out. And there's the tight end coming back across the field. He beats number 37, Joe Todd, and 22 yards on the reception.
Inside handoff. They go back to the ground to Ronald Jean, the little guy, getting close to the 5-yard line. Brought down by number 91, Jim Magda, the senior from Beaverbrook, Pennsylvania.
Again, Ron Jean, number two. He's going to hide behind those offensive linemen, not really trying to find that little slot until the burst of speed is there. He's going to get credit for picking up about 3 yards.
Ronald Jean might wear number two, Marty, but he's number one in the hearts and, of course, in the programs of everybody watching this game. The story you can't tell enough about what that guy has accomplished, and the last things his mom ever said to him when he left her at the bus stop down in Florida, you won't amount to anything without me. Right now he's doing so. Inside the 5-yard line, the completion to Bruce Peltzer as Lehigh gets very close to scoring the game's first touchdown.
Peltzer's going to take it down to about the one. Asher Longden, number 9, along with Jim Emanuel, number 44, to make the stop.
Peltzer had 20 catches on the season coming into this game. I mean, he's Stambaugh, number 7. He just has a million guys he can throw the football to. Third down and one. The ball at the Hofstra 2. 7:03 left in this first quarter. Ronald Jean! Touchdown, Ronald Jean and Lehigh!
Lehigh gets the surge by their offensive lineman, and then Ron Jean, number 2, going to piggyback him in for the touchdown. Ron Jean, number 2, 5'6", 183 pounds. Look at the surge by the offensive lineman, and now the score. Just gets in there, push, and then it's the score.
24th touchdown rushing for Jean, point after tape. And just like that, with 6:57 left in the first quarter, Lehigh leading it by 10-0, taking advantage of a bad fourth down snap on a punting situation. Ronald Jean punches it in for Lehigh.
Great moments in college sports make great memories and often inspire great achievement beyond the game. Come see it all at the Hall, the new NCAA Hall of Champions, a place to relive the action, savor the memories, discover what it means to be a true champion, and that might be the greatest moment sports has ever produced. The NCAA Hall of Champions, opening in downtown Indianapolis in March 2000.
Catch the Nets young, dynamic, determined stars as they strive for the NBA's top prize. Catch some of the Nets' biggest games this season with a Nets 6-pack. For Nets 6-pack information, call 1-800-7-NJ-NETS.
The most powerful name in news, Fox News Channel, on cable 24 hours a day. Fair and balanced with the most powerful names in news. Special Report with Brett Hume, the political show of record. The Fox Report with Paula Zahn, powerful information. The O'Reilly Factor, where news is a contact sport. Hannity and Combs, right battles left. The Cavuto Business Report, powerful business. Fox News Channel, the most powerful name in news. We report, you decide.
Early on, perhaps a surprise, the third seed Hofstra trailing 10-0. A little bit more than half the first quarter has been played. Carl Reuter, along with Marty Lyons, Jaron Tafe will kick off for the third time in this first quarter. This a short kick. Oh, Morales and Thomas, lack of communication, still loose. Hofstra has absolutely no clue on that kickoff and lucky to recover.
Well, you got Billy Morales and you got Robert Thomas back there. Both of them looking at one another and watch where the ball goes. Right between them. No, you got it. Joe Gardy has got to take his squad and sit him down, because if Lehigh jumped on him one more time, this game may get out of control very early.
Joe Gardy said earlier this week he feels much better prepared than 2 years ago when they went to Delaware and lost in an opening round game. He said they really didn't do much on Thanksgiving, kind of really didn't focus all that much on football. Said he felt much, much better about being at home, sleeping in your own bed. So far, it has not shown.
We haven't seen it.
Trips to the far side. Charlie Adams, the reception, immediately hit by number 30, Matt Salvatierra.
Well, the key is now for Carmazzi to get into some sort of rhythm. Remember, he's the leader. He's got to take this offense and give your defense a break. Let them go back, make the adjustments that they have to make. But there is the guy that can do it. Number 19, along with number 88, Charlie Adams. Good numbers for the season. Remember, Charlie Adams, only a sophomore.
Trips to the near side, gain of four on the last reception. Second down, six, shotgun Carmazzi. Charlie Adams somehow slipped through, runs into his own man, picks up the first down. Tom Marrero with a good stop, but it'll be credited to number 25, Matt Andrews.
Tom Marrero is going to get the first daddy of the afternoon. He's an offensive lineman making a stop. Watch the adjustments by number 88, Charlie Adams. Two steps, comes back inside. And watch the hit by teammate. Woo-hoo! Tom Marrero, daddy.
Once again, Hofstra spreads five wide receivers, trips to the far side on first and 10 from the Hofstra 24-yard line, Flying Dutchman trailing 10-0. Zip over the middle to Steve Jackson. And Jackson very close to another Hofstra first down.
What can you say about Steve Jackson? He's going to take a reception, then turn it into a first down. Picks up 10 yards on the reception. Short pass. Leave it up to your receiver to get the job done. Watch Steve Jackson. Breaks back inside. Over pursuit by Lehigh. And then he picks up the first down.
Clock winding down, 5 minutes, 30 seconds left, first quarter. Lehigh on top, 10-0. Oh, some zip to Steve Jackson, dropped at the Lehigh 46 by number 16, James Young, and number 24, Abdul Byron, a 19-yard pickup.
Steve Jackson's gonna run a seam pattern straight down the middle of the field, breaks it off a little bit. Here's the pass. The reception, the results, 19 yards.
All-time leading receiver, Steve Jackson. That's 1999. He'll add to those today. Carmazzi sharp from the get-go, 6 of 7 for 67 yards. Flares it out. This is Tom Kemper. Kemper turning the corner along the near side. Run out of bounds at the 38-yard line. But number 9, Kevin Joseph, the senior from Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
Carmazzi's starting to spread the ball around a little bit. Number 83 is Tom Kemper. 5'9", 175-pounder, only a sophomore. 16 receptions before that one. Two TDs on the season.
From the Lehigh 38, second down and two. Steve Jackson in motion near side, had movement on the line. Jimmy Jones to the 31-yard line, I believe 92. The tackle, Trey Slayton, Marty, was the culprit.
Slayton's going to jump off sides, basically a free play for the Flying Dutchman. Carmazzi knows it. Off sides.
I think they would take the play. It's a gain of 8.
Offside, defense, decline, first down.
And the referee, Jack Winter, saying that Hofstra will take the play. Remember, again, the officials out of the Atlantic 10. They spot the ball at the Lehigh 30 on first and 10. Lehigh leading it 10-0. First round of the 1AA playoffs. Jimmy Jones right up the gut. Jimmy Jones close to the 20-yard line of Lehigh.
And the Dutchman doing some trap blocking up front. Another look at it, you see the blocking. Tom Marrero, number 75, doing an excellent job. And then Jimmy Jones doing the rest. picking up 8 yards. Sets up a 2nd and 2 for the Flying Dutchman.
Nearing the 4 minute mark of the first quarter, Hofstra sets it up 2nd down and 2 with trips to the far side. Jimmy Jones, 1st down and more, driving it down inside the 15, stopped by number 90, Michael Emery, the senior from Atuncha, New Jersey.
And again, the key block this time comes from an offensive guard, number 73, Michael Curry, replacing number 55, Mike Rossigno, out with a stinger in the neck. May not see action at all today.
Rossigno is dressed. Offensive line coach Kyle Flood did tell me in an extreme emergency, Rossigno would do battle. Shotgun Carmazzi on 1st and 10. Fake the inside handle. Carmazzi on the key. Carmazzi inside the 10, and he's dropped at the 8-yard line by number 24, Abdul Byron.
Carmazzi's got a two-way option. He could pitch it to Kemper or keep the ball. Watch number 83, Tom Kemper. He's going to come into your picture, the underneath pitch man. Instead, Carmazzi's going to keep it. And he's going to be stopped by Byron, number 24 of Lehigh.
They will measure whether or not they have it. And that's what they need, just inches, Marty. So it's 2nd and inches for Joe Gardy and the Hofstra Flying Dutchman. Gio Carmazzi, whose parents could not make this trip, back in California watching his mom, Gloria, his dad, Dan. His dad couldn't make it because he's in the high school football playoffs. Carmazzi's dad has a team that's 11-0 and looking for the section championship. So far, this drive has gone 3.5 minutes. Hofstra has gone 82 yards on 9 plays, looking to cash in here. Second down and inches for the Flying Dutchman. The ball at the Lehigh 9-yard line. Guess who has done it many times this year, going right over number 61, Dan Zorger. Carmazzi should have more than enough for that first down.
And what can you say about number 61, Dan Zorger? Only a sophomore at 6'2", 273, played every snap this season.
He's out of Noblesville, Indiana, is Dan Zorger. Jason Stanley, number 98, checks in on the defensive front for Lehigh. 1st and goal, Flying Dutchman from the 7. Hofstra trails 10-0. Trips to the near side. 2:55 left, first quarter. Movement, and it's on the left side. Tom.
This play took entirely too long. Tom Rare, 75, jumps off sides. The audible is on. You see Tom Rare moving a little bit too early.
First down.
That's a long time to leave those offensive linemen in a set position, though.
Although Marrera blaming himself, the senior from Yonkers, New York. What a great guy, young man Tom Marrera is. Has become a stand-up guy, a leader, since the passing of John Champy. Hofstra now on a 1st and goal from the Lehigh 12 following the 5-yard penalty. 2.5 left, first quarter. Motion, Steve Jackson, 21.
And he flag again.
He did not get it off. Back to back 5-yard penalties for the Flying Dutchman, making it 1st and goal from the 17-yard line.
Game. You see Carmazzi's walking over to the sidelines. He wants to know he's got to get the plays in earlier. Especially if he looks up, the defense is not going to be suitable for what the play selection is. He tries to audible. Right there, he gets caught again. Back-to-back, 5-yard penalties.
The play coming from the offensive coordinator, Rob Spence, in the booth upstairs, to the receivers coach on the sideline, Dave Brock. 1st and goal from the 17, Hofstra with trips to the near side. Jackson again in motion. 21. Jackson connects, trying to duck under. He was dropped at the 14-yard line. Once again, James Young, number 16, Johnny on the spot.
And that's a tough pass right there for Cormazzi to make. He's going to throw all the way across the field. Number 16 is James Young for Lehigh. A split second earlier, could have made the interception, would have taken it the distance. As you look at Cormazzi's number, 7 of 8 for 70 yards.
But you would never know by looking at those numbers. Lehigh's on top, 10-0, with 90 seconds left in this first quarter. A fumble converted to a field goal, a Fox fourth down snap on a punt turned into a Ronald Jean touchdown. Busted play, and Carmazzi's busted it well at the 13-yard line. Number 98, Jason Stanley, all over it.
Again, Stanley doing an excellent job from the defensive line position. Goes outside, nobody's going to block him. 98, Stanley comes right around the block of Tom Marrera. He gets credit for the sack.
Stanley is a senior from Ewing Township, New Jersey. Now whistles.
Timeout.
And timeout by the Flying Dutchman, who seemed totally confused in the first 14 minutes and 10 seconds of this first quarter. The Mountain Hawks from Lehigh down in Bethlehem, PA, are on top.
The NCAA thanks its corporate partners who dedicate financial resources, talent, and expertise to help emphasize the vital role intercollegiate athletics plays in society and in the overall development of student athletes. The support of higher education by these outstanding corporate citizens also provides funding for NCAA youth programs and NCAA championships. The NCAA and its corporate partners together building a better experience for our student athletes.
Howard Stern thinks he's outrageous.
Rawr! Godzilla Rabbit.
Martha Stewart says he's a good thing.
Harry, stop it. I can't see it.
And he's live twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays at 8 on Metro Pets.
This is an interesting bird here.
Join animal wrangler Mark Marone and his furry friends. Get great ideas to help you better understand your cuddly creature. Watch Metro Pets with animal wrangler Mark Marone, Tuesdays and Thursdays at 8.
Only on Metro Learning. Let go. Yeah.
Romantic piano music and flowers. Rare and exotic furnishings. Decor that evokes images of a bygone era. Experience our commitment to the highest standards of excellence, the finest quality, and the ultimate in service. Join us for a unique experience in an atmosphere of rare luxury and pleasure. Create memories that will endure forever at Chateaubriand.
Back here at Hofstra Stadium, Hempstead, New York, Carl Reuter along with Marty Lyons. And Marty, right now, Hofstra faced with a third down and goal from the Lehigh 13 early on in this quarter. In fact, almost the entire first quarter, Hofstra playing like a deer in headlights. I stole that line from you, sorry.
Thank you.
Okay, trips to the near side. With time, lofting it, Steve Jackson is inside the five. Down to the three, stopped by Kevin Joseph, number 9. And I think the right move is being made. Try to get some points on the board. They send out Chad Johnson.
Well, they really do, and they got to get Chad Johnson on the same page. Field goals this year, only 6 of 16.
He's had two blocks, Chad Johnson, the junior from Lake Forest, California.
And you talk about blocking them. Lehigh has blocked two field goals this season.
This kick will be from 21 yards out. Art Aselta to do the holding. Hofstra is on the board. A three-pointer from 21 yards out by Chad Johnson. A big kick early on as the first quarter comes to an end at Hofstra Stadium. Coming back with the second 15 minutes right after this timeout.
That dude doesn't know his own strength, man. Putt-putt is a finesse game. Like last week, knocked off of Mr. Blinky's nose, took out Captain Bly's other eye over there at the Pirates Cove. A lot of hot chicks coming in. Just obliterated the windmill of doom. That slap shot of his may work for him on the ice. But around here, that guy's becoming a big liability.
Hey! I just put that back on! Watch out!
Hold your hand even higher and into the fire we go.
Lies. Torture. Betrayal. Just your typical New York romance. The Scarlet Pimpernel, Broadway's most intriguing musical. For tickets, call Ticketmaster at 212-307-4100. Myth is the past we cannot escape.
The heads are gone.
Taken by the headless horseman.
Mystery is the omen we cannot face.
Some say it is the witch of the western woods who has made a pact with Lucifer.
Madness.
Who's there?
Is the terror we cannot stop. Sleepy Hollow, rated R, now playing in theaters everywhere.
And watch the excellent job, Ralph Levitas, number 35, done. Field goal protection, he steps back, takes two defenders, rushing, and still, Abdul Byron, number 24 for Lehigh, gets the tip, but the ball goes through. Good job by number 35, Rob Levitas.
Rob Levitas, a product of Great Neck, New York. His mom had a whole bunch of the guys over for Thanksgiving. A lot of the guys that live around the area, they went home, they stayed here, and his mom, Barbara, and her husband, Archie, they hosted a whole bunch of guys for turkey.
Rumor has it that she had more legs or drumsticks on her turkey than John Madden did on Thanksgiving Day.
I would say so. I could easily see that. I think Madden had six. Chad Johnson slipping on the kickoff on the wet field. Picked up by number 80, Dustin Grande, bringing it over the 30-yard line. But Chad Johnson, we had torrential rains here last night. The field was squeegee, but Johnson, lucky, did not pull a hamstring.
But you have to ask yourself, Chad Johnson came up, warmed up on the field, and remember, Lehigh has kicked three times. Their kicker didn't slip. Another look at Chad Johnson. Plants, slides out. Very lucky that he got a piece of the ball.
First and 10 for Lehigh. The start of the second quarter. The Mountain Hawks on top by seven. Making the catch, Bruce Peltzer, the tight end, over the 40-yard line.
Peltzer wide open.
Third catch of this football game.
Playing Dutchman scoring drive, 14 plays, 87 yards, capped off by Chad Johnson, 21-yard field goal. As Lehigh starts to move again.
Breaking it out over Lehigh's 40-yard line on the third reception of the game by Peltzer. Stambaugh drilling it. Oh, he's got Fedorcha. Fedorcha trying to get loose and dragging Robin Thomas about 10 yards inside the 20. The leading receiver on the team, number 83, Cody Fedorcha, going 38 yards.
Again, no pass rush. He's going to go back. Fedorcha is number 38. He makes the reception. Check that. Number 83 makes the reception. Fedorcha.
Goes 38.
I knew I had the numbers just in the wrong order.
He came in with 67 catches back to the ground. It's Ronald Jean. Close to the 10-yard line. Casey Mahoney was trailing the play, trying to drag Jean down by his feet.
Well, how many times have you heard the old saying, you win the battle up front in the trenches? Right now, Lehigh offensive line just knocking the snot out of the defensive line of the Flying Dutchman and Hofstra.
Is that what they say?
Woo!
Knocking the
snot out, Carl. Old football term.
Get those bubbles in there as well. Dropped over the middle. Tough ball for number 14, Rick Moore, to come up with. Rick Moore from Glen Olden, Pennsylvania. A junior wideout on this Lehigh Mountain Hawks team. That's coached by Kevin Higgins, his sixth year, great record of 42-23-1.
Joe Gardy now sends in his nickel package, an extra defensive back.
Here's Higgins, 1977 graduate from Westchester University down in Pennsylvania. Third and four, over the middle, wide open at the six, Bruce Peltzer. Good for a Lehigh first down.
Good decision. Phil Stanball, he's going to go back three-step drop. He's got a big target in his tight end of Peltzer. 6'4", 238, three steps. Look for the tight end, number 82, Peltzer. And then they wrestle him to the ground, but not until he picks up a first down. First and goal from the six for Lehigh.
Lehigh looking to extend a seven-point lead. Motion near side 87 was Endler. Ronald Jean is stacked up by the Hofstra defense that gets very, very stingy when the opponent gets into the red zone.
And number 35, Rob Levitis, coming back in the game, making the stop. No gain on the play.
The senior who has fought his way back, Levitis, from knee surgery, sat out all of last season. Second and goal, high snap. Stanball pulls it down, drills it, and he threw it behind a wide open Rick Moore.
Good penetration by number 92, Damon Sinacropi. He thinks Gene's got the ball. Good ISO right there on Ricky Moore. Comes across, drags the back of the end zone. Nobody around him, and a ball is thrown behind him.
Stanball, the senior, invited to play in the blue-gray all-star game. Gio Carmazzi will play in the senior bowl. Ronald Jeans got some lane and then cut off. Jim Emanuel stopped him and slowed him down for Rob Levitis, number 35.
What a key matchup out there, 101. Emanuel at 235 pounds matched up with Ron Jean. And then the good pursuit by number 35, Levitis, comes over to make the stop.
Brings on Jaron Tafe for a 20-yard field goal earlier in this first quarter, connected from 23. The kick is good. Lehigh leading again by 10 at 13-3, courtesy of Jaron Tafe.
Tafe getting credit for it, but their offense just bang, bang, bang right down the field. You get inside the red zone, and then the defense decides that they're going to play the game, and they stop him.
I'll tell you right now, there's one guy out here, Kevin Higgins now talking to the side judge working this football game, Steve Kirk, but talking a long conversation yesterday with Jimmy Emanuel. He said, I remember that game we lost a couple of years ago. I was a sophomore, Casey Mahoney was a sophomore, and we remember the end of the game and we lost. We said, well, we're only sophomores and we'll get back there. Well, last year they were denied. The door was closed on the playoffs. He said, I cannot believe my senior year is here and we're back in the playoffs. And he said, I will not lose this football game tomorrow. I will do everything that I need to do. Jimmy Emanuel said that yesterday. He's psyched to be in the playoffs, but just getting here wasn't enough. They want to win at least a game and move on.
Well, that's a sign of a good leader, but what he has to realize too, you need 10 other guys out there on the field doing their jobs, and you need the special teams to do their job. Right now, in the first half, the special teams have not been out there performing well. They've made key mistakes. Fumbling the opening kickoff when you're expected to take the ball, get your offense into momentum of the game. What do? They fumble the very first play. Now they find themselves in a hole, trailing by 10.
I'll tell you right now, you cannot take off any play in any one football game. And in particular, once you get to the postseason, there is no time for rest. It's not just the Jim Emanuel. He needs the other 10, as you said, Marty. This will be Robert Thomas from the 15, far side. Number 50, Tom Oropeza.
Number 25, Matt Andrews going to get called for a face mask on Robert Thomas.
Thomas was trying to turn the corner, the flags came in. This is Robert Thomas, the sophomore from Port St. Lucie. The indication by the referee, Jack Winter, on number 25, Matt Andrews. So Hofstra will better its field position because of this upcoming call.
Personal foul, face mask on the kicking team, makes it a first down.
25 from Lehigh coming into your picture. Right up here, he reaches up, pulls him down, almost got a piece of the jersey. Instead, it was the face mask, and you see the flags coming in.
So Hofstra will start from its own 33-yard line, 11:47 left first half. The Mountain Hawks from Lehigh leading it 13-3. Mountain Hawks averaged 42 points per game. Hofstra came in, they averaged 33. Drilled over the middle for a first down to Steve Jackson at the 44-yard line.
Steve Jackson does an excellent job. This is around his shoelaces. He's going to go down, make the reception. Picks up 12 yards. Top of your screen. Cuts down inside. Look at him go down, handles the ball. Big time reception.
Steve Jackson has been hot of late. Last week became the all-time leading receiver. So far in the first half, Jackson has hauled in five for a total of 54 yards. Trips to the far side. Carmazzi looked near side, now looks back. And is there a pop there by Matt Andrews on the intended receiver? Number 88, Charlie Adams.
Carmazzi's going to focus on the left side of the field. If he looks in the middle of the field, he's got Billy Morales wide open running a post pattern. Instead, he elects to throw it out to number 88, Charlie Adams, and he pays the price by Matt Andrews, number 25, coming over making the stick.
Second down and 10 for the Flying Dutchman. Andrew is a junior. This snap will come from the Flying Dutchman 44-yard line with 11:18 left, second quarter. That ball was tipped. I believe Ian Eason, number 41, Marty, got his hand on it.
Eason shows great quickness, good awareness, feels the pass coming out, jumps up, knocks it down. Very aggressive defense here for Lehigh. Number 41 jumps up and knocks it down. Ian Easton, number 41, a senior.
Third down and 10 for the Flying Dutchman. In motion, Billy Morales goes to the far side, number 11. Wide open, over the middle, Charlie Adams to the Lehigh 35. Brought down by number 25, Matt Andrews, but a key block in the backfield was Jimmy Jones, adding protection time for Carmazzi.
And a 21-yard reception for Charlie Adams. Going down, finding the soft spot in the defense, wide open, makes the reception, tucks the ball away, picks up 21 yards.
Early on, elsewhere, 1AA playoffs, Florida A&M leading App State 6-0 second quarter. From the Lehigh 34, a first and 10. Steve Jackson was not going to be able to short hop that one and pick it up.
Had to be a little Derek Jeter out there if he was.
Derek Jeter, well, let's be fair and or say Ray Ordonez for those Met fans.
Bounce about 2 yards short of him.
Or I'll take my favorite, Ozzie Smith, the Wizard of Oz. For many years with San Diego and then the St. Louis Cardinals. Joe Gardy's team needs a touchdown here, Marty Lyons. 10:44 left in this second quarter. Unlike the Flying Dutchman to be held without a touchdown this long. On second down and 10, trips to the near side. Carmazzi's flush, but he's got some room. Tucks that shoulder and he barrels his way towards a first down. Number 5, Nico Carwell, the junior from Reading, Pennsylvania, stopping Carmazzi.
Carmazzi needs 10 yards to pick up the first down. Nobody's open downfield. Again, a sign that he's matured as a quarterback. He looks over toward the sidelines. He knows he needs 10, picks up 11.
10 yards in the first down.
This drive started at the Hofstra 33-yard line. It's down to the Lehigh 24. Jimmy Jones, the ball carrier, picks up 2 to the 22. Dan Guzovich, number 53, the senior from Kenilworth, New Jersey, on the tackle.
Guzovich, number 53, at 6'3", 248 pounds, undersized as a defensive tackle, makes up the difference with his quickness and his strength, makes the stop.
Undersized at only 248 pounds. 9:45 left first half. 2 split out to both sides. Second down and 8. With time, Carmazzi looking for the paint. And yes, a flag has been thrown for pass interference. I believe it will go against number 24, Abdul Byron.
Steve Jackson's going to look at the official. ISO right there, number 21, straight down. There's the bump. A little grabbing going on right there by number 24. Abdul Byron, and you see Steve Jackson, he's going right to the official.
Pass interference on the defense.
Byron, number 24, is a sophomore from Elizabeth, New Jersey. The ball spotted following the flag at the 7-yard line of Lehigh. It'll be first down and goal for Hofstra from the Lehigh 7, 9:29 left, first half. Hofstra down 13-3. Inside handoff, Jimmy Jones. Jones cracks the 5 down to the 2. Matt Andrews, 25, stopping the play.
Trap blocking up front by the offensive line. Michael Curry, 73, does an excellent job sealing off the defender, and Jimmy Jones does the rest.
And right back, touchdown for the Hofstra Flying Dutchman, Gio Carmazzi.
And number 12 for Carmazzi on the ground this year. Anytime you get it inside to 1, number 19 likes to do it himself. Another look at it, Carmazzi. Defense is never set. The push and the score. Number 12. Rushing touchdown for Carmazzi.
I'm sure his parents, Gloria and Dan, very happy as he makes an equipment change, Carmazzi. Chad Johnson for the point after. And Johnson banks home his 49th PAT of the season. Carmazzi marches his team 67 yards. The Flying Dutchman are right back in it.
It would have been easy to have been a football player and not a student. And conversely, it would have been much easier to have been just a student and left football for some other day and time. But it wouldn't have been as joyous, as rich, as humbling to have been one without the other. So for all of us, I say thank you from the bottom of my heart, not for a single award on a single night, but for the many memorable and molding moments that we have had the privilege to call ourselves student athletes.
When is a cable company more than a cable company? When they have a staff like this, technology like this, choices like this, and a name like this. When is a cable company more than a cable company? When they give you more than cable. Cablevision.
The Nets young, dynamic, determined stars as they strive for the NBA's top prize. Catch some of the Nets' biggest games this season with a Nets 6-pack. For Nets 6-pack information, call 1-800-7-NJ-NETS.
Gio Carmazzi just marched the Flying Dutchman 67 yards to pay dirt, culminated by the one-yard touchdown plunge by Carmazzi himself. 12th time this year Carmazzi has rushed into the paint. Took just under 3 minutes for the Flying Dutchman to score their first six-pointer of the afternoon. Ronald Jean, 3 yards deep, takes the knee, first and 10, Lehigh, from its own 20-yard line.
And that's what Joe Gardy wanted Chad Johnson to do last time. Remember, very strong wind blowing out of the north today. Got to get the ball up in and let it sail.
Boy, last week, I mean, more and more, I think meteorology is your next career. Last week it was the knots. This week the wind is blowing out of the north.
Now let me see, Carl, how many years did I take?
You said a lot.
Three.
I said three because you liked it so much.
I really did.
Stambaugh has lived up to all the billing that we have heard about. Reverse, Rick Moore trying the near side, but Robert Thomas stringing the play out.
Robert Thomas makes the stop, but if it wasn't for your number 44, Jim Emanuel, watch the play in number 44. He's going to read a little razzle-dazzle by Lehigh, comes back inside. Watch how he stretches the play. And then staying at home is Robert Thomas to make the stop. Loss of four on the play.
Going back to Jim Emanuel, he was banged up during the course of the season. He told me he was a little disappointed in his production, but he's been healthy the last 3 weeks. He is playing a big-time game right now.
But you also know that he's playing out of position, his true position, outside linebacker position.
Swinging the stand ball, but not able to haul it in was Ronald Jean on that little flare. This a big play for the defense of the Flying Dutchman on a third and 14. Lehigh pinned back on its own 16 for Kevin Higgins and company. Part of the big crowd here for the Flying Dutchman on its feet. And now, of course, on the far side, the contingent that came up from Pennsylvania will try to outnumber that cheer. Might be the biggest crowd here earlier this year for the open against UConn, had almost 10,000. Wide open, Ronald Jean. Driven out at the 29-yard line. This will be very, very close.
I'm going to go out on the limb and say that he's just short.
Yeah, why? Because you saw the punt team come out for Lehigh?
No, I saw where they spotted the ball over here. Designed play, though. Very close to picking up a first down. And the Dutchman should get excellent field position. You see Billy Morales back deep to return it.
Jay Heibel will do the punting. Heibel this year, 36 kicks, averaging just a little bit more than 39 yards. Billy Morales is Mr. Excitement. And now he'll be joined back there by number 32. It's a double safety, J.R. Santos. And now Robert Thomas comes on. They got three men back awaiting this punt. Trouble again, covered, and the Flying Dutchman seems like all sorts of problems on special teams. J.R. Santos went back, then Robert Thomas was back. I've never seen three men back to field a punt. And there's Robert Thomas, arms extended, number three.
And Joe Gardy over there having some words with one of his coaches about this special team play. Another look at the end of it. You see Billy Morales, number 32, is Santos. He's not going to handle it cleanly. You see Robert Thomas, he's back there.
Well, there is the talk. Joe Gardy with his special team. Number four was Chris Crank.
Number 48 is Jason Howard.
Flying Dutchman with the ball. Good field position. Starting this drive at the Flying Dutchman 38. Jimmy Jones struggles and gains four, perhaps five, depending on the spot. 8:22 left in this first half. 13-10 Lehigh. Mountain Hawks got off to a quick 10-0 lead. There's Vaughn Sanders, the senior. Thumbs up. Injured. Broke his foot. Back against UMass, 7 yards shy of becoming the school's all-time leading rusher, but in spirit, very vocal on the sideline with his teammates.
Shotgun Carmazzi fake to Jones.
On the run, complete. Steve Jackson steps up and has some room. Steve Jackson cuts back to the 25-yard line. Brought down by Abdul Byron. 32 more yards for Steve Jackson.
You have to like the way Steve Jackson plays the game. He makes the adjustment for Carmazzi. Carmazzi comes out of the pocket. Watch number 21 out there. Watch him hit the brakes. Brakes. Defender goes by him, but watch the hustle by Byron, number 24, to get back and make the stop.
Can you do that one more time?
What, when they skid?
Yeah, the break.
You see that?
You can't do it now because
You got to have that sound effect when you see the water sliding up off the turf.
You like that, don't you?
You got to still look at Joe Gardy. I think he's very concerned, even though his team's only trailing by three, making a lot of mental mistakes in the first half.
We're ready to put it back into play on the signal from referee Jack Winter. Hofstra on the move. The ball at the Lehigh 25, 7.5 minutes left in this first half. Tom Kemper comes in motion to the near side. Flag, and let's see what happens on this one.
Should be some movement by the offensive line.
Dead ball.
Prior to the
ball
snap.
Start, offense.
And it is. Push it back five on the illegal procedure call on the flying Dutchman.
Right there, trying to blame it on number 77, Corey Holland.
Corey Holland is a transfer from Delaware State. He's out of Berlin, Maryland, 6'3", 290-pound senior. First down, 15 from the Lehigh 30 for the Flying Dutchman of Hofstra, who set it up with trips to the far side. Lehigh with a three-point lead at 13-10. Jimmy Jones caught from behind. Nice play, open field tackle, number 20, Brendan Moore.
Brendan Moore, number 20, 20 on 20 here. The safety valve is number 20. Jimmy Jones coming out of the backfield. Brendan Moore is number 20 for Lehigh, making the stop.
And if this was a call-in show, you would say Brendan from Bluebell is on the phone. Bluebell, Pennsylvania. 6.5 minutes left in this first half. Last play, picking up 8 to the Lehigh 22. Jackson banging helmets at the 15-yard line. Once again, banging with number 24, Abdul Byron, with help 16, James Young.
Number 59, the right tackle, Michael Burgandy, is going to make a key block downfield. You see the release. Now watch Burgandy, number 59, makes the block. And then Steve Jackson does the rest, picks up a first down.
Ball placed at the Lehigh 14-yard line. First and 10, Flying Dutchman. Shotgun Carmazzi. Jimmy Jones bobbles. Jimmy Jones regains. Jimmy Jones to the 9-yard line. Little juggling act there by Jones, who was tackled by number 35, Brian Appling, the junior from Lithonia, Georgia.
What a first thing you have to do before you can run with the ball. You have to catch it. Jimmy Jones is going to juggle a little bit, but he still picks up 4 yards on the reception.
Hofstra driving. This a second down and 6. 5:15 left, first half. Inside they go to Jimmy Jones, and Appling right there makes the big time play.
Appling coming from the backside, showing excellent speed as Lehigh comes with a blitz. Number 35 is Brian Appling. Comes from the backside, makes the stop, sets up a 3rd and 7 situation for the Flying Dutchman.
All right, now the Lehigh contingent wanting the big defensive play against Hofstra with trips left. Kamal Roy split out near side. Carmazzi rolls. Drills! Touchdown, Steve Jackson!
Carmazzi has to help. wide receivers coach, Dave Brock. Play action. Tom Marrera outside and watch the strike and the catch.
Steve Jackson, 8 catches, 104 yards, including that six-pointer just moments ago. Flying Dutchman with its first lead of the game. Chad Johnson, the point after. Flying Dutchman trail 10-0, now leading it 17-13. 4.5 minutes left in this first half.
Mottled sunlight beams through leaves of sycamore, maple, and oak. Waterfalls trickle over river-washed stones. Nestled in a woodland hideaway, the Fox Hollow invites you to rediscover the call to elegance, quality, and the desire to experience the ultimate in a fine catered affair. The Fox Hollow, a commitment to excellence, and a promise to create memories that will last forever.
Home with Christmas, the rockets are all a-dancing, the choir is a-singing, the sleigh bells are a-ringing, never was there ever such a Christmas show.
The Radio City Christmas Spectacular.
It will fill your heart with Christmas, taking someone that you know,
someone that you love,
to see the Radio City Christmas Show.
Call today.
Good look right there, Steve Jackson.
How you doing, Charlie?
Saying hello to the folks back at Paoli, Pennsylvania.
Middle of your screen is number 21. He runs the post pattern, comes across. No defenders are there. Carmazzi's going to throw a perfect strike. Low angle view at it. You see the block by Tom Marrera. Wide open lane. Steve Jackson's going to do the rest.
Steve Jackson has had a tremendous last 3 weeks, including today, 28 catches for 442 yards and 3 touchdowns. And he doesn't even know if he really wants to play football.
I know, Carl. We were talking to him before the game. He's talking about maybe going into modeling.
Well, he's got that look.
Another avenue that he might want to pursue.
Might. He's a communications major, is Steve Jackson. So if it doesn't work out here where he takes over for you next season, you'll go to modeling. How's that?
Take over for me.
Yeah. Well, if Jackson comes up here, maybe you'll go into modeling then as a second career.
Oh, you better. From what I understood, he was trying to be a play-by-play.
Oh, I thought, no. Well, he plays the game.
You can always go back to the sideline. There's another option for you.
Thank you.
I have to talk to Bullet Bob DePoto.
In attendance today, Chad Johnson to boot it off. Gene again takes the knee 5 yards deep. First and 10 Lehigh from its own 20-yard line. So Chad Johnson not giving, whether it be Ronald Gene or number 23, Jamal Bercher, an opportunity to bring it out.
Well, again, that's what you expect when you have this strong wind coming from the north to the south. You see Kevin Higgins right there, like to get his offense back on track. Now trailing by 4.
With 4:24 left. Whoa! Big hole. Senior running back can't haul him down. Number 39, Brett Snyder.
Snyder's going to pick up 23 yards straight up the middle.
The brother of number 7, Josh Snyder from New Tripoli, Pennsylvania. That's not bad to come in for your first play and pick up a big chunk of real estate. Wow.
Flag on the play, though.
Is that real estate staying intact?
Sideline warning on Lehigh. That's their first. It's a warning.
I have never seen that sign. It looked like he was trying to push all the people closer together in the seats. I really don't know what that call is.
Well, whatever it was, it didn't cost him any yards. A warning to stay back beyond the white.
It's possible. Stamboff goes far side. Joe Todd missed the initial hit.
Kerry Williams.
Endler, excuse me, Marty, number 87, the receiver.
Kerry Williams hustling out from the defensive end position to make the stop.
Clock is winding its way down in this first half for Kevin Higgins and the Mountain Hawks. Quickly out to a 10-0 lead, but Joe Gardy's team has taken it back at 17-13. Lehigh with twins split out to the near side. Lehigh will work different formations throughout. Fedorcha brought down immediately by number 3 Robert Thomas inside Hofstra territory at the 49-yard line.
And just shy of the first down. Stanball goes back. Fedorcha makes the reception. And a good strong tackle right there by number 3 Robert Thomas. Third and one.
Fedorcha comes from Slantington, Pennsylvania. What a great town for a receiver. Get it? Slant. Slant. Doesn't want to respond, Marty Lyons.
That was a good one, Carl.
Thanks. Where are the knocks from today? How much are those knocks? They're blowing out today. Ronald Jean stacked up maybe a yard. And I don't know if he got that first down on third and short.
He's just shy of it. Good, strong tackling. Number 22, Casey Mahoney in the game now.
Mahoney is a senior from Forkett River, New Jersey. Big banner hanging up for some of the seniors in the north end zone for Sinicropi, Mahoney, and Magda.
Three good ones.
There you go. Done an outstanding job. 92, 22, 91.
Adam Brown also in the game, number 43, better known as Pudge.
And folks, that is permission from Adam Brown. And that is short. Now Kevin Higgins, big decision, 2:42 left. You're trailing by 4. You need inches. You're at the Hofstra 48.5 yard line. What are you doing, Coach Lyons?
I'm going for it. It's the playoffs. I got to show my offense some confidence, but I don't exchange the ball.
So you're going to take a quarterback sneak with Stamball.
Remember, Stamball, 6'4", 221 pounds, 4'8" on the season.
That's not a bad number at 50%. Remember, they lead the nation in third down conversions at 55.9%.
Here we go.
You got the big fullback in front of the little guy, the tailback, Ronald Jean. Quarterback sneak and the stretch. Let's see if they give him that forward motion. Now the pressure is on the referee and his crew.
I'm saying he's short. If they mark it from where I see it, he's going to be just shy.
Jim Mayer, defensive end number 81, was popping and whooping and
agreeing with me.
Yeah,
I'm going to say he's about 2 inches short.
Well, we're going to bring the chains out from the far side. Oh, this is a big play, because Hofstra will get the ball at pretty much midfield if they hold with 2.5 minutes left.
Here we go.
Oh, by the tip of the football, Marty.
As I was saying, he was going to make it by just about 2 inches.
By the tip of the football.
We call for a quarterback sneak. Watch James Emanuel up over the top. Stamball is going to move out of his way. Otherwise, Emanuel would have hit him headgear to headgear.
Might have been that last surge, the stretch of the arm by Stamball. The drive stays alive. Ronald Jean, Joe Todd, flag in the backfield. Ball to the 45-yard line, but let's check out the flag.
This one's coming back, holding.
Would be called on number 57, John Babb, the junior from Newark, Delaware.
Jim Magda, number 91, trying to get pressure on the quarterback.
Pretty much the only way you can keep Magda away, Marty, is to hold him. Babb 57, the culprit.
Holding.
Magda being very quiet today out on the field. This is a young man as a defensive lineman, led the team in tackles and sacks. Almost unheard of a defensive lineman to do that.
And again, a real nice young guy. A young man who really held himself well on and off the field for Joe Gardy's football team. Trips to the near side. First down and 20. They go to the draw to Ronald Jean. Not much happening. Maybe a yard. Joe Todd, 37.
Again, Joe Todd showing excellent speed, staying at home. Good, sure tackle. Wraps him up around the legs.
You know, Marty, Joe Todd's got the strength to play linebacker, but I think his big asset is the speed, as quick as guys that play the secondary. To be second down and 18, the ball at the Lehigh 44-yard line. Ronald Jean so far came in averaging over 150 a game. 11 carries, only 33 yards. Shotgun stand ball, flare to Ronald Jean. On the cutback, Jean dropped at the 47-yard line. James Mayer, first one in attendance for the Flying Dutchman.
Ron Jean's going to make the reception. Even though he doesn't make the tackle, Robert Thomas comes in outside, forces him back inside, and watch the hustle by number 81, James Mayer. There's the cutback, there's the tackle, good pursuit. Third and 15.
James Mayer will be back. Number 81 is the junior from Somerville, New Jersey.
Getting a lot of playing time. That Malik Corbett went down a few games ago.
He's been banged up, Malik Corbett. On third and 14, combination there. Adam Brown, and you said he was quiet. Jim Magville woke up.
Well, they're going to run an end tackle game. The end slant inside. The tackles come back around. And the two tackles meet back at the quarterback. Here's the quarterback. Tambo goes back. There's 91 coming in. And backside touch. Number 43. They're back there. Yes.
Jim fell down. The first ever to sign a scholarship here. Adam Brown, number 43. There's Jimmy Magda, but Adam Brown, originally from Deer Park, Long Island, about 40 minutes from here, now out of Margate, Florida. But hey, that's a combination of some big beef there with Pudge Brown and Jimmy Magda.
But you got to give credit to those defensive ends. They basically sacrificed their bodies to free up the defensive ends. And I might, Carl, I might just have to draw that up for one of the highlights at halftime. Show people at home why that play works.
All right. And Hofstra calling time, Marty, forcing Lehigh to punt into the wind. And the Flying Dutchman, with 42 seconds left on the clock, will look to take advantage of that win before they go into the locker room. So what you're saying is those magic crayons of blue and red and black, they're going to diagram some defense. I wonder why.
I want you to admit I've actually taught you something about the game this year.
Okay, fine. Heibel on to do the punting. Second one in the game. His first punt going 36 yards. Will be kicking to a trio. Once again, Thomas near side, Morales in the middle. And letting this one roll, and it rolls dead at the... Nice roll, still rolling, still rolling. Is that the final roll?
Comes to rest at the 27-yard line.
The final roll. 35-yard punt, no return. 25 seconds left in the half. And Hofstra first and 10 from its own 26-yard line.
Woo, Joe Gardy says, wow, I spotted him 10 points. I'm up by four.
And you know what? That roll took 17 seconds off the clock.
Got to be pretty proud of the way his team came back, responded.
Now, there's Jim Magda, equipment problem. Coach Joe Gardy sitting on this?
Yeah.
Or do they go for a home run in with the win?
I'm saying he's going to sit on it.
Hofstra will sit on it and just run this out. And the Flying Dutchman, who trailed early on 10-0, will go off to the locker room, leading it by the score of 17-13. Little turn of events for the Flying Dutchman. Hopefully we'll be able to speak with the head coach of the Mountain Hawks from Lehigh, Kevin Higgins. I see getting set along the far side. Coach Higgins, do you hear us? Coach Kevin Higgins.
can hear you.
Okay, Carl Reuter along with Marty Lyons. Coach, the team got off to that quick start. What was that difference there? We're now Hofstra with a four-point lead.
Yeah, Marty, that's what we needed to do in this game with all the emotion, especially at their place. We need to come out and get a jump, and our kids made some great plays early. Hofstra's a great football team. I didn't think we were going to shut them out. I knew they'd have an opportunity to come back. We are where we need to be now at halftime. We just need to keep this thing close in the fourth quarter and find a way to get it done.
All right, Coach, thanks for the time, and good luck in the second half.
All right, thank you, Marty.
That's Coach Kevin Higgins from the Lehigh Mountain Hawks. His team trailing by four. We're coming back with more right after this timeout, Marty.